The Honourable Member for Concordia.
Madam Speaker, yesterday the Federal Health Minister wrote a letter to the Saskatchewan government demanding that they end their private pay MRI program. Mm-hmm. She cited their significant concerns that private diagnostic services defy the fundamental principle of the Canada Health Act and that access to care should be based on medical need and not the ability to pay.
Here, here.
Despite the evidence, Manitoba's Minister of Health admires Saskatchewan's program so much that he's looking to recreate it here in Manitoba. But Madam Speaker, it's clear, universal and equitable health care is not just the right thing to do, it's in fact the law. I ask our Minister of Health, does he agree with the federal minister?
The Honourable Minister of Health, Seniors and Active Living.
No.
The Honourable Member for Concordia on a supplementary question.
Well, thank you, Madam Speaker, and that's very disconcerting because in her letter, the Federal Health Minister warned that under the Canada Health Act, provinces who charge for medically necessary services will in fact have their federal health transfer payments deducted dollar for dollar.
Well, that sounds smart.
Madam Speaker, after the federal government cut the provincial health payment transfer payments in half, Manitoba can't afford to lose any more health care funding. Will the Minister of Health...
Good job, Matt.
Will the Minister of Health admit that his plan to integrate private MRI services in Manitoba is a bad deal for Manitoba families and that Manitoba's health care system can't handle it?
The Honourable Minister of Health, Seniors and Active Living.
Well, Madam Speaker, the member has come around. He's come around to understanding that what the federal Liberal government is doing in reducing transfer payments to Manitoba by up to $40 billion, Madam Speaker, over the course of the next 5 years is devastating to the province. To lose that $40 million would be terrible for our health care system. He has finally understood that, Madam Speaker, how difficult that would be. What Saskatchewan was trying to do, Madam Speaker, was try to look for innovation and to do things differently, exactly what the federal minister has suggested be done. And now to turn around and say that innovation isn't going to be accepted is not the right thing to do. We stand with Saskatchewan in looking for innovation and other provinces who are looking for innovation as well, Madam Speaker.